Hello, my dear friends, students and parents. All of you know, recently I have made a video on New Education Policy 2020. But today's video, my video on this particular quality of education, infrastructure and etc. Are new amendments in education policy sufficient to see the change in this country? Let's talk about that. So first I am going to start with KVs and Navodayas. We have thousands of Kendri Vidyalayas, Navodayas. Actually, they strictly run on the basis of CBSE syllabus, we know, and their English medium schools, no doubt. So as per the government announcement, they are telling that up to class 5, I mean grade 5, it is compulsory to study in Telugu medium, I mean Tamil medium, Hindi medium, whatever it may be, that regional medium. But whether it is compulsion or option, still they have to confirm. If it is a compulsion, then some teachers in KVs and Navodayas are teaching from other states, like some teachers from north are teaching in south, some are from south are teaching in Gujarat and etc. So they don't know even regional language of that particular locality. So this is going to be a problem. So if English medium an optional, English medium or regional medium is an optional, there is no problem. If regional medium is compulsory up to class 5, then some teachers have to be transferred from that particular state to their own state. So this is one of the problems in that one. But I hope government is working on this. So they will take very good decisions on this. Okay, appropriate decisions. Like let's talk about medium restrictions. As per the announcement of our Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister Modi ji, so yesterday he told us that up to class 5 regional medium facility is there. Facility is available. So it is still not clear that up to class 5 that regional medium or local medium or your mother tongue is compulsory or option. If it is option, that is already there all over the country. You can take your regional, I mean mother tongue, or you can take English medium, any medium. You can study in your regional language or English medium. So that option is already there. But if it is compulsory, then it's okay. I mean, if it is compulsory, then KVs and Navodayas, some problems will be there. They have to sort out the problem. But if it is not compulsory, then it is going to be very huge discrimination between students of middle and upper middle class and students of poor and lower middle class. Because we know that parents of middle class, above middle class, rich, they desperately want to send their children to English medium schools. If you start English medium or regional language, if you start English regional language only in government schools, not in private schools, then parents won't send their children to government schools because they desperately want to send their children to English medium schools. So this is going to be huge discrimination between students. Okay, only some kind of students, those who can afford money can go for English medium school. Those who cannot afford money, they have to read in regional language. So this is going to be a very big problem. So I hope government won't take this kind of decisions. And up to class 5, medium, mother tongue or regional language must be mandatory. So next, rural and remote areas. You see, still many parents of rural and remote areas, they are still desperate to send their children to urban areas because as per their thought is concerned, what they think, in urban areas education quality is good and in rural areas education quality is substandard. Actually, this is not their thought. That is true as well. In many states, in some central schools also, in rural areas and remote areas, teachers are not available. Permanent teachers are not available. In KVs and Navodayas, some permanent teachers are there. Actually, in KVs and Navodayas also, many teachers are contractual teachers. Government has to recruit permanent teachers in KVs and Navodayas to maintain quality of teaching. So what I am telling now, in remote areas, some teachers, although permanent teachers, they don't want to go to remote and rural areas. This is another problem in our country. So government has to ensure that the quality of education is same in rural areas and urban areas. Then only we can see almost equal growth in the quality of education and the innovative ideas of students as well. Teacher quality, this is totally miserable in India, because in many states and many areas, like urban areas and semi-urban areas, the quality of teaching is good. In some state government schools it is good, central government it is good, no doubt. But when it comes to rural and this remote and remotest areas, it is very, very miserable. And moreover, in central government schools also, the teacher quality is miserable, because I am not talking about permanent teachers. In KVs and Navodayas, permanent teachers are there. Sainik schools also, permanent teachers are there. Though the quality of education is very good, but when it comes to contractual teachers, they are not giving their performance up to the mark. So I hope government will recruit the posts, vacant posts, or the contractual posts of central schools by permanent teachers as soon as possible. So teacher quality must increase. Next, infrastructure. As per the latest announcement by central government, we know that they are going to give some options. I mean, not options, for every student it is compulsory to participate in extracurricular activities like singing, dancing, some yoga, sports and etc. So we don't, we must not talk about private and corporate schools. When it comes to government schools, how infrastructure is there? So infrastructure must be enhanced, okay, because in many government schools, the facilities are not there. So as per the government announcement, they are going to increase 4.43 to 6% GDP for this investment, not investment, for this particular development of infrastructure in schools. Next one, CET, Common Entrance Test. We know in India, for all medical aspirants, there is a single exam, that is NEET exam. But for JEE aspirants, still many states conduct some common entrance test, like in Odisha, OJEE, Maharashtra, Maharashtra SET, Chhattisgarh SET, Andhra and Telangana, MSET, like that. So when entire syllabus is integrated, entrance test for JEE must also be integrated. Okay, already this is not highlighted in the announcement, but overall they said that there is going to be a single exam all over the country. So I hope they will conduct only one exam, that is JEE mains, or after that JEE advanced for all JEE aspirants. So these are just my suggestions to improve quality of education in the